Hey everybody, this is Bo back in the lounge. We want to say hello to the 1.5 million listeners all across this globe. And right now, we've got a special treat for your wrestling fans. We're going out to the U.S. Army Wrestling. Get a chance to talk to Coach Barbie. Sir, how you doing?
Hey, I'm doing good. Thanks for having me on the show.
You know, Coach, one of the reasons we contacted you is that we've got a lot of military bases across this country that tend to tune in for mixed martial arts and wrestling. And of course, we didn't, over the last year, get a chance to talk Army Wrestling. You've created quite a success for yourself there.
Yeah, well, we're working hard here. I mean, West Point is a great place to come and get a world-class education, wrestle for Division I national titles. So, I mean, Army fans have got a lot of ways to watch wrestling with All Army and the Army World-Class Athlete Program. Of course, the Black Knights here at West Point. So we're working hard to try to represent the Army and the country well. So.
Absolutely, you certainly have, Coach. Now, in the scheme of things, the D1 programs have been sort of slowing down as far as adding wrestling. In the lower divisions, wrestling seems to be exploding in many different forms.
Right.
And in U.S. Army, how have you seen that growth?
Well, I mean, the Army, just wrestling and grappling and combative type actions is just a natural extension of the Army. And a lot of the guys we get here, we see here at West Point, not only a strong interest in people wanting to be on the program, but just a strong interest in grappling and submission fighting and people just wanting to get on the mats out there and kind of test themselves against somebody else. That's what wrestling's all about. It's kind of unique, and you know, you can put a ton into it, or you can just do it a couple days a week. Of course, our college guys are training 6-7 days a week to try to be national champions, but there's a lot of other ways to enjoy the sport of wrestling too.
Well, I think one of the big things that has really helped out wrestling in all programs is the explosion of MMA, obviously. And I think the biggest thing for MMA is the college-educated wrestler that steps into the pro ring is some of the best qualified and best trained fighters in the planet. I think there's a lot of pride factor in American-style wrestling dominating all forms of combat fighting. It's got to be a pretty big kick in the arm for you all as well.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's, you know, wrestling is very, very unique in that I remember back when I was in college at Oklahoma State, a buddy of mine, Chris Barnes, who was a national champion, we used to, for fun, we used to play a game called chokeout, you know, so, and we just basically got on the mat and tried to get each other in choke positions, and then right before we would tap out, we'd say, okay, you got me, you know, so it is kind of a group that enjoys those kind of unique challenges like that, and you go through your life as a wrestler, and it really hardens you up to some tough situations that you might see inside of any sort of ring you're in, and so that's hard to simulate over just a couple of years' time if you're a boxer or somebody else trying to get into it. I think wrestlers have a unique advantage there.
Well, I think in the program you have at Army is unique because there, I said the unique three times, now four times, but the typical athlete you have is a little bit different than the typical university. There's a certain calling, there's an individualism, there's a passion, and when they come to the wrestling table, there's a lot more than a traditional student gets to look at on the wrestling side in your Army program.
Yeah, oh yeah, you know, the West Point asks a lot of them, that's for sure. And our guys are certainly special because they don't sacrifice any academic or career or wrestling goals. They do it all, and they just love to get into the room and blow off some steam. And it's a great avenue for just going out there and just getting after it. And when you're wrestling and competing hard against somebody one-on-one, you're not really thinking about anything else except that battle right in front of you, you know. So, and then, you know, when they get done, they can kind of switch it off and they go back and they study for their tests and exams and do that stuff. But, yeah, we got a special group of guys because we're, you know, working every day to put guys on the podium. We've had national finalists, and they're going through the same rigors as every other cadet here, and they're producing on the mats for the most part, so.
Absolutely, Coach. Now, the one thing, too, is that you've got some juniors and seniors that are stepping up. You obviously got some underclassmen that are, you know, certainly wet behind the ears that have a lot of learning to do. But who are those guys that are really helping out in the off season and really making sure that the young guys follow through with your program?
Yeah, well, we've got a great group overall. I mean, coming back, we've got two returning national qualifiers in Richard Starks and Matt Kyler. Matt Kyler was an All-American in 2008, so we expect both of those guys to really go for the gold this year and try to be on the top step of that podium. We got another co-captain, Ryan Mergen, who's going to be doing, I think, going to really have a great season. Casey Tom was an academic All-American last year, you know, so we've got a really, really good group of guys here that I think are going to step up, and we've had probably one of our best recruiting classes, maybe since I've been here in the last 9 years, coming in with a lot of talented freshmen, but our seniors will be the one that will help us the most. I expect all of them, we only have, I believe, 4 seniors, so I expect all of them to step up and really help and produce, so.
Yeah, there's a lot to be said for that senior squad, whether it's a junior or obviously a senior, that can really help you out as far as training, egging people on to compete at a highest level. When you get a freshman into a program like yours, a lot of them are probably similar to the same freshmen on most universities. But with that said, they're making a certain call to go to West Point versus going to University of Ohio, you know, go down to,
yeah,
you know, Rocking, you know. There's just a special person that has. But even with that said, how much learning curve do these freshmen have at West Point now?
Well, you know, going to college is a huge learning curve, like you alluded to there earlier. I mean, it's like they're getting slammed in the face with so many new things, and that's no exception here at West Point, that's for sure. But, you know, in my experience, I've been at University of Oklahoma and wrestled at Oklahoma State and wrestled and coached here for 9 years at West Point. And, you know, it depends on the kids. Some kids need 6 months to a whole year to kind of get it, you know, and turn that corner. And there's some of those special ones, like we had Phillip Simpson, who was a 3-time All-American for us. And he, after about couple of months, man, he was turning things around and issuing out some butt kickings is not only just taking them, you know. So it really depends on the kid, and I haven't found that to necessarily be any different here versus any other school I've ever been at. You just got to really try to coach them individually, bring out their best, and most importantly, they got to go in with a game face and a mindset that they believe that they can win that match no matter who it's against. So
absolutely. Now, Coach, did you have an opportunity to go down to Fort Lauderdale in hurricane season and meet with the rest of the coaches?
No, I did not get to do that.
Now, Coach, I'm trying to figure out why they would send you to Fort Lauderdale in hurricane season when you guys already travel in the worst part of the season for any sport. I know up here I follow my boys in high school, and it seems like we're always driving in monsoons or, you know, hurricane-force winds.
Sometimes the logic is a little bit fishy, but I'm not sure. I'm not sure what the rationale was there. So.
Awesome. Coach, thanks for taking so much time with us. We're going to ask if we can give you another call in about a month as you get closer to wrestling season.
No, we'd love to do that. Make sure, you know, just to check out the Army wrestlers at GoArmySports.com. Our schedule's up there, and we'd love to, you know, get emails or calls or stop by for a match.
Absolutely. Coach, thank you so much. That's Chuck Barbie from West Point Army. Thank you, sir.
Thanks a bunch, Bo. Bye-bye.
Goodbye. We're off the air.